Okay, I'm gonna change my big pulley on here. It's my 24 tooth pulley. So I need to get a little more speed for the spindle. Well, I'm setting up the C axis. I'm gonna calibrate it. I got a quick little setup here. A little Sharpie witness mark and a little piece of wire pointing to the center of it. I'm gonna go to the calibration page, set steps for unit. C axis. How far would you want it to move? I want to do 5 revolutions, so it'd be 1800. Tell it okay. That still looks pretty right dead on center. So I did a calibration with one. Since it still looks like it's right on mark, I'll put my 1800 back in there. My axis is set 2.221 steps per unit. Yep. Okay. Got a little growl there. But it's calibrated pretty accurately, I think. 5 revs and then went right back to the same spot. Enough for me. Could try to do it with, I don't know, 10 or 20 revs. Double check, make sure it's still goes back to the same spot. But that's pretty close, I think. Okay, I'm running the speed of the motor. I have spindle set up 810 steps per, and with 45,000 hertz, if you go the max, it's 3333, and I know that's what the motor peaked at, but it couldn't keep up. I was getting faults, so I lowered it down to 3000, and that's what I set my max spindle at, max pulley at. Turned it on, running at 3000 RPM. I can verify it. Right on 3000. And it's been running here for 5 minutes, no fault, so I think we can run at 3000 RPM. I'll tweak it some more, try to get a little higher, but I know 3333 at fault. But with my pulley ratio, the spindle ought to be seeing about 3426. Still, that's half of what I can get with running off of the KBMM 125, but this is only running at 72 volts versus 120 volts, so got to accept that there's going to be a reduction, but it's still a servo, and we do plenty of milling, and main reason for it is for tapping and such. And I can also have, I have a switch, I can flip it back and forth to run the motor either off the servo or the KBM 125 with my C6 hooked up, so I could still have, you know, Mach can turn the spindle on and that and varying the speed, but through the KBM 125, and I can get, you know, about 6800 RPM out of the motor. And let's see, 1.142 times 6800, that's about 7765 at the spindle with the KBM 125, so yeah, it's about half. But it's servo, still running strong. And get on the mill, do some milling tests and tapping and all that other good stuff. Okay, I tried it again. Spindle. That's why steps per at 810, 45,000 hertz kernel speed. Works out perfect for the velocity, whatever you put the velocity at, that's what the RPM you're going to get. I tried 33 again, the max it'll go to, and it faults. It did pretty quick. I set it to velocity to 3200 now, and it's going pretty good. Hasn't faulted. Right on. $3,199, $3,200. I think that's what our max speed can be. Of course, that's not under any load, but it's easy to adjust the speed under motor tuning. I'll re-figure out what my max RPM will be. Okay, it's still going at 3,200, so I think we got our speed, at least for now. And with this pulley ratio, I'd see 3,654 on the spindle, roughly. That's better than the stock mill. That's the big ratios I can get with these big L-belt pulleys. I can get a bit higher ratio if I went with the smaller XL belts. But I like these big L-belt pulleys. Okay, I'll set up my pulley again. See, pulley one, max speed 3,200. Okay, and then the spindle speed, 3,200. That's what it should run at. I have about 2 second acceleration on there. So nice speed up, slow down. Yep, there we go, we're getting 3,200. And let's see, if we put it at 1,500. See how close Mach is. Pretty dang good. 1,500. Alright, I'll try 200. Pretty darn good. 200. There you go. Set it that way, or whatever you tell it go, that's what it's going to go. Okay, and then input speed number M3S2000. There you go. 2000. Speed works too. M5. M4. S250. Back the other way. Pretty close. M5. How about M4 S100? Like M4, you know, backwards. 100. M5, M3, S50. And pick it up. There you go. 50. about M3S10. Oh, yeah, this will pick it up. Eh, too slow for this to pick it up. Oh, there it goes. 10 RPM. Full spindle control. All right, now we gotta get it on the mill. Do some permanent wire.